got from our parents also. So kayo, ano ba, do you have parenting tips na you find yourself practicing from your parents? Mga namana niyo from your parents?
With regards to how...
In general.
My mom would always tell me to stop, taking it seriously. You know, she would always say, you know, you have to relax in motherhood. Before naman, wala silang, it's too much info right now, right? So, like, me kasi every time my kid gets sick or, like, there's a rash, I check online, and then sometimes she starts freaking out, diba? So she goes, like, you know what? Just rely on your doctor, stop researching online, and sometimes you have to just, you know, take it slow in motherhood. Don't stress too much, and don't let the pressure, like, come. So, for me, she would always tell me, just relax. That's what she would always tell me.
So mine naman would have to be my mom's kasi the type that she sort of like lets me be. She allows me to do my own style. But maybe she would advise me to continuously spend time with my children, have a good relationship with them, invest time with them. So those are tips that I take with me, and because my mom was also that way, my mom was very proactive in raising us. She did really everything for us, even if we had help. She would cook our food, she would tutor me, she would take me to school. So those are the things that, tips that I saw my mom modeling that I'm doing now with my kids. And also some words of reminders that I would do also.
And it's true though when they say you become your mom.
Oh yeah, there are a lot of things like I find myself sounding like my mom.
Yeah, and then you'd be like, now I understand.
Yeah,
now
exactly.
I understand.
Yeah.
In line with that, are there traits of yours naman that you see in your kids? Parang that's me.
I think Scarlett, she's very motherly. And I remember when I was also her age, I was very motherly. I have two brothers, so I have an older brother and I have a younger brother. But it felt like parang I'm really the ate because I'm the only girl. So I really overlooked the things there at home. When my mom would be out of the country, I would be the one on top of things, even if I was young. So with that, I was able to really take that with me when I started having my own home, when I started raising my own kids. Parang I was trained early how to address issues in the household, how to do things at home, how to clean. So I see that in Scarlett. Parang Scarlett is very motherly. She's very, she does a lot of things of services. So yeah, she'll ask you, like, how can I help you? Do you need me to do this or do that? Sometimes she doesn't even ask you. She already does it because she knows you like it. And then with Kendra, I have a little bit of everything with the kids. Eh. With Kendra naman, she's a very good teacher. So, parang I can leave her tutoring the children. And I see a lot of my parang patience in teaching with her. And she explains very well. And then Gavin, he's just very Gavin. Happy lang. Be happy lang. He's a bunso. So, yeah. What about you?
Yeah, me naman with Ollie, because she's the eldest, and I'm also the eldest of five. I see a lot of myself in her. Like, you know, I'm strict, and she's also very strict with her younger sister. So I said, you're very adamant, you know? I mean, even if one palang yung sister niya, I think we have another one coming, I can already see it. Like, I already see myself in her. Even the way she talks, or even the way she corrects her sister, it's very maate, and it's very like me. So that's her side. And then with Amelia naman, she's very, like Scarlett, very off service. Like, she's very manabig, she would do things for you, and she's also, you don't even have to ask her, sometimes it's already done. Mm. And parang at the age of 4, parang to see
so
that, it's so responsible. And then sometimes, like, Olivia's more of the stricter one, more of the stricter one. Amelia naman, she's maalaga.
Kasi diba, since you both have several kids already, how different were you as a new mom? Tapos now na medyo veteran moms na kayo. Kasi diba, minsan pag a new mom, yung parang natataranta sa germs and stuff.
Yes. I remember when I was a first-time mom with Kendra, parang all the things, you wanna make sure that you do it parang correctly. So yeah. You're so pressured. You're so and then you're an overthinker.
Yeah.
When you're a first time, I'm pressured, overthinker, and then parang all for a lack of better term, parang lahat ng best things and best everything. Parang
and like you were a germ freak.
Yeah. You know, there was even, I don't know if you've ever done this, but when Kendra was an infant, I would watch her sleep and I would put my hand on her chest just to make sure that she's breathing.
You'd wake up in the middle of the night.
Hello. So, parang you're more uptight when you're a first-time mom. Syempre, there's no handbook naman for parenting. Yeah. So, parang in a way, parang you're making kapa. Your parenting style or how you do things, and then on your second baby you're more relaxed, on your third parang okay. And I think a lot of moms and a lot of parents can relate to that kasi parang your first one is your trial of all of these things, and then come your second you basically have it, on your third you've already winged it.
When they're newborn, right? Like, when you can touch your baby, if you need to wash, or if you need to naligo.
And you just don't hand your baby just to
anybody, diba? Or sometimes, like, when somebody kisses the feet, you're like,
wait, wash.
So, I was more concerned about germs. Even when she was starting to walk and move things, parang lahat na lang ng ginagalaw niya. Wipe. And then when my second came, I need to pass the cards. You can have a little chill.
When your third one comes out, you're super chill.
I know.
Yeah. Sure. So, this start, even the kids nakukuha nila yun with the parents, yung parang, I need to wipe, hand sanitizer, clean. And then earlier, the doctor was saying, there are good bacteria, bad bacteria pala. So, how do you balance it with your kids? Kasi medyo chill na kayo ngayon, diba? How do you balance it with your kids since the pandemic? Kasi we also have to be extra, you know, the kids have to be extra mindful about the germs. But at the same time, we were saying kanina, let them go out, let them
play. Of course, because we went through a whole pandemic, how many years of pandemic, and we're still in it.
Yeah.
But then, I think what happened was we were also able to create like healthy habits that maybe we did not really impose on too much with our kids. And now a lot of those pandemic babies, parang they already know how to wash their hands, they already know how to make sure that their hygiene is clean. I think that's okay. But I think, you know, we should remember also to let our children go out, to enjoy the outdoors, to have playmates, to go to the playgrounds, because as what Dr. Phil said, that there are good bacteria and there are also the bad ones. And, you know, it's important that we also have our good bacteria so that our immunity can also fight it. So that, you know, we get to also exercise our immunity.
Yeah. You have to have the balance.
Yes.
And, like, my daughter, she was born during pandemic, so she was a pandemic baby. So, you know, when we first went out to the mall, to her, it was like, she didn't want to touch anything, diba? Because we would always say, don't touch this, don't touch that. Even the package that you get at home, you know, you have to spray and wipe, or sometimes even wait a day. So parang that's how she grew up, and we had to like re-teach her how that it's okay. Like sometimes she'd be like, Mom, can I touch this? She'd be like, Mom, can I talk to her? So she would make paalam. So we had to say that it's okay. You can play with her, you know, you don't have to ask me. You can go to the playground, you can do this. So it was a lot of re-teaching for me when it came to like my second one. And then with Olivia, it was really just teaching her the healthy habits and, you know, of washing the hands.
I think healthy habits is good. Yeah. Teaching healthy habits for kids is good. I think what becomes hard is when we don't allow them to be able to be kids and to enjoy the outdoors or to socialize with other children. So we have to relax on that.
How do you... Kasi, diba, sometimes for parents, it's hard for them, lalo na the first-time parents. But how do I explain such a concept, a complex concept to my kids? Do you, how would you say it? Para medyo may tip na yung mga new parents. Para may explain yung
concept of having
being clean, but then still having fun, and then there's good bacteria and that bacteria.
I think you just relax. I mean, you know, it doesn't have to be so by the book, you know. Mm-hmm. Just
them be kids.
Yeah, let them be kids and enjoy. And then, you know, on your conversations, like, I'm sure the kids, they're very curious and they'll always ask, why do I have to take this?
Yeah.
So you have to be generous also in explaining to them. And when you're generous in explaining to them, it's just like...
It's easy for
It's easy for them to understand. It's like homeschooling. So we're teaching to them what the gut does and why the gut is important, and you know, all of these things. It's interesting. Even us adults, diba? It's interesting for us. So I think, you know, you just have to just relax.
Yeah, and explain really well to the kids. Because they're, I mean, even at a young age, they will understand it already. Or you can, there's a way of explaining to them that they will understand. So it's really the communication.
It's a lot of conversations.
Yes. Events like this help them see and realize why, you know, gut health is important.
Yeah.
And then, of course, us parents, we have the responsibility to keep reminding them and including that healthy habit into their dailies.
Yeah. Okay, I'll keep it light for my last question. Kasi, di ba, moms, they usually have a lot of things in their bags. What is, the pag-bring me, di ba, laging, mga moms, laging kompleto yan. What's your top five things in your mommy bag na pag lumalabas, kailangan meron kayong ganun in your bags?
Well, I'll go. I have my wallet. And then, of course,
is this for the kids or for us?
The kids.
For the kids. My kids are ano na, medyo I don't have a parang baby bag na. My kids
they have their own bag.
They have their own bag. So they have wipes, they have sanitizer. When my daughter goes out on cuz my eldest, she goes to regular school na. So she's no longer homeschooled. So she had like a big like camping mission work. So in her bag, she had her, of course, her toiletries, but she also had her medical kit. So she has everything that she might need and needs. So her vitamins are there, her probiotics, her supplier was there, because outdoor education.
Yes.
So they were in the jungle, they had to do a lot of things. And when her classmates were having like a bad stomach, which is a true story, she was able to give them because she had her supplier kit. That's Kendra. And then, so me, even when I travel, when I go abroad, I always have Air Soflora kit.
Yeah. So now it's part of
It has always been part of our kit, and it has always been part of our lifestyle. My kids have been taking probiotics ever since.
Yeah, same here. There's a bag for every day, but there's a bag for travel. And since we live in the South, you know, it's also, and you live far off, you know, like coming to this, and you have to be prepared with everything. So like it's really like the medicines that you have. And my kids, parang sometimes a change of weather, my siblings doesn't have that. So and with that, you already want to give medicine or vitamins, or you know, sometimes you know they'll have a tummy ache. Could be the water that they drink, you know, or like the ice that's not clean.
Or so the food also.
Or the food also, diba? Yeah. And my kids are very sensitive tummies because the dad has sensitive tummy. So I always have to be prepared with medicines like Air Soflora. Then of course you have the wipes. We have extra change of clothes because babies, pa sila. We have snacks and then water. So those are the usual things.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.